Привет! Here we are studying Russian with visual material, with movies, cartoons, series and so on. We are trying to understand native speakers without getting lost in translation, with real pronunciation, contexts and genuine life situations. Today's topic is going on a visit and some verbs of motion. Slavic people are very hospitable, гостеприимные in Russian. We like receiving guests and visiting people as well. So the very first expression we'll learn is ходить в гости, which is quite confusing as гость is a guest, but the whole phrase means going on a visit. That is to say, going to someone to be a guest there. As you see, we employ a verb of motion here. In fact, they can be various. So let's first see some examples.
Кто ходит в гости по утрам, тот поступает мудро.
Винни-Пух thinks that going on a visit in the mornings is wise in general. Ходить is a multidirectional verb used when you move in different directions. It is also used for regular movements, usually, often, sometimes, which is quite logical, as to frequent, attend or visit a place or somebody several times, you have to go back and go there again.
А куда мы идем?
К тебе, конечно.
Идти is a unidirectional verb. The friends are being on their way right now, moving towards a definite destination. By the way, pay attention that when we go to somebody, we use a preposition к plus dative case.
Мы, пожалуй, к тебе не пойдем. А то получится, я иду в гости, а ты не идешь.
Here the friends decided to change their destination, so пойти is a perfective form of идти, and it is often used when you begin moving, set off, or start on a trip.
Ага. Тогда пойдем к тебе.
Even if you use this verb in the past, we never know if you actually reached your destination or not, because you focus on the fact that the motion has started. Пойдем is imperative, let's go, and it is also the future form for me. We can use other verbs with в гости, for example, приходить, прийти, to come. So if you invite somebody, you'll use imperfective, приходить, приходи, приходите, ко мне в гости, come and visit me. Here it implies a general invitation.
Слушай, приходи ко мне в гости.
А никто не прогонит?
Ну что ты? Дедушка только вечером придет. Давай, прыгай прямо в окно.
If you accept an invitation, you'd use perfective, as it is a single occasion. Я приду, or if you already come, я пришел, пришла, мы пришли. Another verb we'll frequently use in this situation is заходить and its perfective form зайти, to drop in, at, come over, stop by.
Это, есть хочешь?
Спасибо! Заходи, если что.
Here the wolf is inviting the dog back and reminds the dog that he can count on him. The imperative forms заходи, заходите, here you can use в гости, is the perfect way to invite somebody to your place, to come over and stop by. Заходить, зайти are also used to denote dropping in or at a place, on your way, accidentally or maybe on purpose.
Я говорю, мы как раз шли мимо, я случайно подумал, а не зайти нам кролику.
Pay attention that we use к plus dative case with заходить. Винни-Пух was hoping to get some treat from the rabbit, so they decided to stop by and visit him. Just before they dropped at the rabbits, Винни-Пух was saying that the rabbit must be a good company, where they can be offered a treat.
А кролик — это подходящая компания. А подходящая компания — это такая компания, где нас могут чем-нибудь угостить.
Винни-Пух is sure that the rabbit is bound to treat them with something delicious. So he is using the word угостить, which is the perfective form of угощать, to offer a treat. Pay attention to the cases we use with this verb.
Привет, малыш, чем будешь угощать?
Пирогом.
С чем?
С 8 свечками.
Ну нет, это я не ем, что такое, 1 пирог и 8 свечей. Лучше так, 8 пирогов и 1 свечка.
Поверь мне, Карлсон, не в пирогах счастье.
Ты что, с ума сошел? А в чем же еще?
Угощать is to treat somebody with something. You can also use reflexive forms. Угощаться, угоститься, and imperative угощайся, угощайтесь, which is help yourself or treat yourself.
Угощайтесь. Салат, рыба, птица, икра. На десерт будет шампанское с фруктами, потом кофе с конфетами.
So, we've seen several episodes with some verbs of motion and useful vocabulary for going on a visit. I suggest going to the beginning of the video and watch the episodes again to make sure you understand the phrases, contexts, and learn new vocabulary. Once you've done that, you can check your knowledge with the following quick test. So the first question is, что здесь делают Винни-Пух и Пятачок? What are they doing on this picture? You should say that in Russian. Ответ. Они идут в гости. If you invite somebody to come over to your place, what can you say in Russian? Ответ. Приходи ко мне в гости. Приходите ко мне в гости. Заходи. Заходите ко мне в гости. Do you know help yourself in Russian? Ответ. Угощайтесь. Угощайся. Hope you've done well with this test. If you still have some questions left, you can go back and watch these episodes again. If you're interested in full cartoons, you can find links in the description. Thank you very much for your attention and hope you'll join the next video as well.